Zaspojanko po diablanom, mile moje drage, lepe moje crne oči, pogledajte na.
I know because of the terrible terrorist attacks in Paris of November 2015 that people might think that a lot of these people were terrorists that came through. Our trip was mainly a humanitarian trip. We were there just to help people and to serve at that location. We wanted to help them with their medical needs. There were children, there were families, and there were some young people, but the majority of the people were very appreciative of what we did. They blew us kisses, they hugged us, they were really appreciative. Although we couldn't speak their language, we knew that they were very happy with what we were able to help them with. The trip had been planned 9 months in advance. Our group was initially intending to go to Novosad and help community clinics, and especially the Gypsy community, which is called the Roma community. They're former refugees. There were six of us in total. The majority of the people were from the Covina Assembly of God. The group consisted of two medical professionals, myself, a physical therapist, and an RN. And the other people were assisting in the medical missions and also with ministry. We prepared by seeking as many donations as we could. Being a medical missions trip, we wanted to take supplies, medical supplies, because our focus shifted to helping with the refugees. And we knew that the refugees would have medical issues. They would need medications, they would need wound care supplies, just basically humanitarian aid. So we collected as many donations as we could, and that were monetary donations as well as medical supplies. We went initially to Novosad. That was our starting point. And we helped in community clinics. We assisted a doctor there that was volunteering and giving her, using her clinic as a starting point. It was a very big city. It's one of the largest cities in Serbia. We also visited the border towns of Šid, Serbia, and Subotica, Serbia. Subotica was the border town between Hungary and Serbia. We helped refugees there that were waiting for the border to open. And they were waiting in hopes that the border would open. It was closed when we went to visit, but they sat there very patiently. A lot of them looked dehydrated, they had wounds, they had a lot of respiratory problems, and they were sleeping in with no shelter. The other place we visited was the border town of Šid, Serbia, and that was the border town between Croatia and Serbia. That's where the majority of the refugees were coming from. There were buses that deposited the refugees, and they would make their walk through a cornfield, and they were dropped about 2 to 3 kilometers from the border with Croatia. It was very important for us to go on the trip because, first of all, we wanted to help with the medical missions. That was our main goal. We wanted to help the community at large, those that couldn't afford medical care. We wanted to help the Roma community, who was lacking in basic care and supplies, and both women, children, adults, elderly, and we wanted to help the most recent need, which was the refugees. We knew that these refugees would have medical problems, and we wanted to be there to serve them and help them. And our main goal was to help to show that Americans cared And we wanted to show them the love of God. We wanted to show them that God was there with them and was going to help them through their crisis. There were a lot of donations that came as a result of the Eyewitness News ABC 7 report. There were a lot of donations in the communities of Monrovia and Burbank. And I just wanted to express my thanks and the team's thanks for all the donations, all the help, all the prayers and support, because we were able to give of ourselves and the supplies. We actually had enough money to go get backpacks, food, water, basic medical supplies, and we were able to stretch the money a lot. And so I just wanted to thank everybody, and I wanted to let all of you know that you were very generous and you helped to benefit a lot of people. There were thousands of people that we helped, and we couldn't have done it without you. So we're just very thankful to have been able to be a small part of the humanitarian aid at the borders.